Hello everyone and welcome to Cooking at Home. My name is Josh and today we're gonna be making the most simplest and most delicious bacon barbecue burger, but instead of regular bacon, we're gonna be using candied bacon. So stay tuned and check this out. Oh, and for everyone who's new here, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm always reading the comments. I'm always checking that stuff. So I look forward to meeting every single one of you and just talking to you one-on-one. That being said, guys, let's hop onto this video. We're gonna start off by just mixing in our ground beef. We're gonna be using about 3 pounds of ground beef with 2 tablespoons of salt, 1 tablespoon of pepper, and 1 tablespoon of garlic powder. Essentially, we're gonna be seasoning it like a steak. We're not gonna season it too heavy because we are going to season it before we pop it on our grill, or in my case, my cast iron pan, because I actually don't own a grill. So, hey, if you're hating on that, if you're upset about it, how about you just send me a grill, okay? I have no problem with that. I'll take that bad boy to the park. You know, I don't care what Trump says about it. I'm serious. I'll do it, for real. That sounds like an amazing idea, actually. I would love to record outside. That sounds like a lot of fun. Now that we're done mixing our ground beef, it's time to start shaping them. So just go ahead, grab a nice big chunk of it. If you have a scale, definitely weigh them out. If not, do your best to mold them to 7 ounces minimum. That's the standard size of any burger patty that you go to, like at any fine dining restaurant or whatever you want to call it. Just make sure you make them nice and tall, and you don't want to make them too thin or too short, because it's gonna have a lot of shrinkage, okay? Now, I'm actually using standard ground beef, you know, something that, you know, just regular ground beef that you can find at a grocery store. But if you wanna take it up a notch, go to your local butcher shop and have them just kind of ground you up some fresh ground beef right there. You know, that would actually make it just that much better. Once you are done forming your patties, just go ahead and wrap them or cover them and put them straight into your refrigerator. We want them to rest for at least 1 hour, but they're always best if left overnight. This gives it time for all the spices, all your seasoning, all your ingredients that you're using into your meat to actually get into the core of it and just, you know, we'll get more flavor. You'll get more flavor is what I'm trying to say, okay? Now, while our burgers are resting, let's start working on our homemade buttermilk. You're gonna need 4 cups of milk and 4 tablespoons of white vinegar. And if you don't have any white vinegar, don't even worry, don't even trip. Just go ahead and squeeze a lemon. You want at least 4 tablespoons of lemon juice as well. Make sure they're fresh though. Once you pour your vinegar into your milk, just go ahead and give it a little stir and just let it rest at room temperature for around 15 minutes or so. And then you can put it back in the fridge. All you want is that milk to curd. But now the buttermilk is optional. You're more than welcome to go buy some, you know, a quart of buttermilk that's already pre-made and good to go from the store. But if you want to be an all-star, just go ahead and just make it at home. The correct ratio for any homemade buttermilk is just to follow this rule. For every 1 cup of milk you use, you're gonna use 1 tablespoon of either white vinegar or some lemon juice. But make sure it's fresh, okay? You don't wanna use that little, those little bottles that, you know, that taste like, they taste like, well, like powdered lemons, you know? If you have that right now in your fridge, no offense, dude or girl, just toss it in the garbage, buy one lemon, okay? That's all you need. Now, for our knife cuts for our moon shapes, don't worry, a lot of people always kind of say, hey, this sounds a little challenging or sounds a little fancy. It's not, not one bit. Just grab one whole onion and slice it down the center. Next, we're gonna turn it around and we're just going to slice, slice, slice. You want about a quarter, technically about a quarter inch cut, but you don't have to measure it, okay? Just make sure they're nice and thin. Now, if they're looking like half of an onion ring, then you did it too thick, okay? Slice that one right in half. That's way too large. Now they're no longer onion strings. Those are just some half of onion rings, I guess. Now that our moon cuts are ready, just go ahead and mix them around. Make sure you take them apart so they're not sticking together, and put them straight into your homemade buttermilk. Now for the most exciting part for me, it's time to start working on our bacon, okay? So grab a bacon sheet, get your bacon, and just spread it all evenly. I will always recommend everyone to just buy the drip pans for those sheet trays. They are so worth it. They keep your bacon from swimming in its own fat, and it's also gonna keep all of our seasoning from just kind of floating away. We're still gonna lose some, but we're only gonna lose about, what, 20-30%? So let's go ahead and start seasoning our bacon strips. We're gonna season it with brown sugar, salt, pepper, cayenne, and paprika. And we're gonna be doing this 2 times. We're looking for 2 layers. Not only is this for the flavor profile, but most importantly, it's also to make up for the amount of seasoning that we're gonna lose while our bacon's in the oven. Now that our bacon's nice and seasoned, We're gonna go ahead and just toss that in the center of a 450 degree oven and bake it for around 10 or 15 minutes or so, or until it looks a little bit like mine. Now, once it comes out, it's gonna be looking a little soggy, okay? But don't worry, don't trip. Just let it sit and cool in room temperature and it's gonna firm up and get nice and crispy. Oh, cool fact. In case you forget to put your bacon away and it stays out overnight, actually, you're still fine to use it, okay? You don't have to throw it away. Now, I'm not saying keep it for a week, okay? I'm saying like if you left it for like 8 hours or so overnight, literally overnight, okay? After that, now it's kind of gross. Just don't do it. I wouldn't, I don't know, you do you, bro, okay? It's your choice. Great, now that our bacon's in the oven, let's go ahead and grab our barbecue sauces. Now, we're not gonna be making a homemade barbecue because that's gonna take a long time, okay? I will upload another video that in the future, depending if people request it. However, for this simple recipe, we're just gonna use two types of bottled barbecue sauces that we can find just about anywhere. And if you're saying, Josh, whoa, why are you using bottled on camera or why are you using bottled in general? You'd be so shocked to know how many of your favorite restaurants or barbecue joints that you go to that actually don't make their own barbecue at home. They say it's at home, but guess what? They're just mixing two types of barbecue and fusing together, not only because it saves labor, but because it just takes too long in general. And most people don't know how to make barbecue for some reason. Actually, I would love to make the rattlesnake barbecue sauce that I learned in Texas at some point in my life. And by some point in my life, I mean a few years ago. But man, actually that's gonna be a hell of a video, okay? And it's gonna have the whole neighborhood smelling like barbecue. It's gonna be crazy. Okay, barbecue done. Now let's move for our sauce that we're gonna be spreading on our burger, which is kind of like a Thousand Island, I guess, but it's a lot better, okay? So don't get it confused, okay? This one is off the hook. We want our onions to actually still have that bite once we actually bite into the sauce. We don't want it to just kind of dissolve and disappear. It defeats the purpose. Now you're just eating mayo and ketchup. Speaking of ketchup, go ahead and grab 2 cups of mayonnaise and 1 cup of ketchup and just mix them in a bowl. Now grab a saute pan, get it nice and hot, and throw in 3 tablespoons or a nice large drizzle of canola oil, or I guess vegetable oil or anything else would kind of work. I'm using canola. So throw your onions straight into a saute pan and just saute for about, I don't know, a minute or so. And just put a little pinch of salt in there. This is gonna help your onions sweat. Now saute your onions for about 30 seconds to a minute. We don't want them to be too cooked again because again, we want to keep that bite to them. So grab 4 tablespoons of sugar, throw them straight into your onions, and now we're gonna just watch them get caramelized, and the color you're looking for is almost a caramel color, okay? Nice and golden brown. If it starts turning black, start over because you burnt them. Once your onions are nice and caramelized, throw in 2 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce or whatever you call it, and 3 tablespoons of balsamic vinegar. And reduce it to about 60% or so. We don't want them to dry out. We want these onions to still have some liquid into it, but we don't want to make our sauce runny at the same time. Now grab your bowl of mayo and ketchup and just add in your onions and finish it all with a pinch of salt, pepper, and garlic powder. Awesome, we're almost there. Now it's time to just start cutting our vegetables. So cut your iceberg and slice those tomatoes because it's almost time to eat. Now let's start frying those onions. So grab a pot, and no, not that kind, okay? Save that for after. You don't want to burn yourself with this oil just because you decided to smoke some trees and fry at the same time. That's the wrong kind of fried, if you ask me. Now for our seasoned flour, if you don't want to use too much seasoning, don't worry, don't trip. Just season to your liking, okay? This recipe is for you. But if you want to do it the way I'm doing it, just go ahead and add 1 tablespoon of cayenne, salt, pepper, paprika, and onion powder. And while your oil is heating up, pull out those onions that we left marinating in the fridge, get your bowl of seasoned flour, drain, just give them a little shake, and put them straight into your flour. Give them a nice mix. Just make sure that your onions are nice and covered. There's no gaps or anything like that. And sift off any of the excess flour that you have. You don't want to put down your frying oil, okay? That's gonna make it rise and just flood your entire kitchen, okay? I don't think you want to clean up that mess. I know I don't. Now go ahead and place them slowly into your frying oil and just wait until they get nice and golden brown. You don't want to get too dark because they're still going to keep on cooking as they come out of the heat. You don't want to pull them out. You don't want to pull out. Well, you know what I mean. You don't want to pull them out until they're all fully brown because they're going to keep toasting up in their own heat. And it could actually burn as they're resting. So just make sure that they have a nice light brown color and then put them in a bowl with paper towels on the bottom to keep them from soaking all that extra grease that's floating around. It's time to start toasting our buns and cooking our burgers. So just grab a pan or your grill, whichever you're using, and just drizzle a little bit of canola oil right on top of your buns. Now this step is optional. I want to use oil because it works just as fine as butter, but you don't have to. Use butter if you want to use butter. It's all good. Now that those buns are toasted, grab your patties and just season with salt and pepper and chili powder. Now this is technically not a blackened burger because I'm using chili powder, but however, it has such a great flavor profile to it. But if you're just against chili powder in general, which you shouldn't be, just get some Magic Man or whatever blackened seasoning brand you want to use and do it that way. Just make sure you go nice and generous and cover all the edges. Now all you have to do is just cook your patties to your desired temperature. I'm personally going to aim for a mid-rare, so I'm going to cook mine for around 4 minutes on each side. Great. All our prep is done. Our burgers are cooked. Now all we have to do is just melt your cheese on top of your burger and let's start building. So let's start off with our pickles, lettuce, tomatoes. Put your burger on top of your tomato. Hit it with 2 pieces of bacon. Now grab about 1/4 cup of those fried onion strings we made and just kind of press them on top of your bacon, on top of your burger. You know, don't squeeze the life of them. Just, you want to keep them in shape. You want to keep them from falling apart. Then just finish off with your lid, put a nice pick on it just to keep it nice and tall. Other than that, guys, it's time to start eating. Thank you guys so much for watching. My name is Josh. This was Cooking at Home, and I can't wait to bring you guys more recipes and just more stuff for us to work on together. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below, and I will see you guys on the next video. Oh, one more thing before you guys go. This is just something I wanted to share. One of my many goals for this channel is to make some comedies, you know, some funny videos that we can all enjoy and laugh and share with our friends. But I also want to share one of my many recipes and just create awesome recipes for everyone to enjoy and can make at home. So stay tuned for that. Let me know your thoughts. And again, support the channel, guys. Stay blessed. I will see you very soon. Thank you.